Welcome, everyone, to another episode of the VMblog Expert Interview Series. And today we're joined by Darren Siegel, Product Specialist at Specops Software. Darren, welcome.
Thanks for having me.
I guess let's kick things off. If you could, just give us a quick background on Specops Software.
So Specops is a password management company. We've been in business for 20 plus years, and our primary focus for the past several of them is around improving password security for businesses, small, medium, and enterprise, and around improving the password security and password management capabilities for Microsoft Active Directory environments.
Now, one of the things I wanted to cover with you when I found out we were going to have the chance to speak is the concept of honeypots and their primary purpose. Can you explain a little bit about that?
Yes. In general, a honeypot is an intentionally secure system that you use to you put out in the wild, out in the internet, and use it to distract attackers. When attackers are going to try to brute force or run any sort of scans or anything against systems, it's just, the honeypot's designed to look just like a real system. Theoretically, the attacker will waste their time there rather than attacking real production infrastructure.
And how and why does Specops use honeypots?
We use them in a little bit of a different way. We use them to capture the kind of attacks that attackers are using, specifically password-based attacks. So our honeypots are designed to look like what should not be public-facing services in the first place: remote desktop, SSH, telnet. Essentially, these interfaces that are primarily intended to be internal use for remote management. We hang them out in the internet. Attackers find them and they start trying credentials. We capture the credentials they're trying. We can see the usernames, which are more often than not very generic. But more importantly, we can see the passwords that attackers are trying. We can analyze that data, and we can feed it back into our suite that is built around preventing the use of commonly guessed or breached password data, passwords that have actually shown up in public data breaches or that are being used in these attacks. We want to prevent your users in your environment from using those same passwords.
Now, talk a little bit about, what the latest data collection looks like from honeypots. What has it shown you guys?
There's a lot of interesting insights we get from this data. Now, we have a lot of it. First off, we get, the number and the scope of the honeypots, I can't really say, but we get about 200,000 hits a day on these things. So that added up to, that's an average. We got about 4.5 million. In the scope of a few weeks in October, for example. So we can see the passwords there, and we can see some trends. We can see common base terms that you'd expect that are all over the place, like password and welcome and user. Those are all showing up in those passwords. But some more interesting things. 88% of the passwords we see are 12 characters or less. The attackers are not trying particularly long passwords. In fact, 24% of them are exactly 8 characters long. So attackers are clearly focused on the 8 character passwords, the sweet spot. A lot of the passwords are not using terribly complicated character sets either. So, they're simple passwords. They're passwords that you look at them and say, yeah, that's a password that if I'm an attacker, I would try to guess that. But really the length is the biggest takeaway there. 8 being the sweet spot, very rarely seeing something longer than 12.
And is there an easy way for organizations to see if their users are using compromised passwords?
Specops actually offers a tool where you can check for yourself. We'll show that to you here.
Okay.
So what we're looking at here is an offering called Specops Password Auditor. This is actually a free offering. You can download it from our website at specopssoft.com. Just fill out a form. You can download it, run it in your environment. And what this will do is work off of a list of the passwords that Specops has collected. And this is a combination of passwords from public data breaches, your Havoc and Pwn, your combo list, your RockYou, et cetera, and augmented with that data we've gotten from the honeypots. Download a copy of that, and very quickly, you can run a scan against your live Active Directory, and we can show you all of the users in your environment that are using a password from that list. We won't tell you what the password is exactly, of course, but you can see right here, here is, you know, the attack surface where an attacker could, you know, try a password that someone's seen out in the wild and successfully authenticate if they pick the right one. So that's definitely something we'd recommend everyone everyone watching this to take a look at.
Definitely. That was a great great suggestion. I totally agree. That seems like an easy solution for most people. I also wanted to ask you, you know, 2022 has been, you know, a huge influx of remote access. I want to make sure, you know, how organizations can and should be securing their remote access from cyber attacks. Can you share some advice here?
There's all sorts of things we can do here. You know, if we're going to focus on the passwords first, you know, certainly, you know, implement something that's going to block the use of those breach passwords. You can also augment that with the solution, you know, like the one SpecOps offers with SpecOps Password Policy to deploy a custom dictionary to block other common key terms and passwords, terms that might not be in the breach list, for example, seeding the name of your company or the name of your products or other key terms relative to your business and keeping all of those out of passwords. Push for longer password length. The attackers are going 12 or shorter, go 13 or longer. Right there, you're making it much more difficult for the attackers. The other things we can do beyond passwords, yeah, certainly don't lose sight of multi-factor. Don't look at multi-factor as a solution to ignore passwords. Multi-factor fatigue can happen too. We've seen it where users just automatically hit accept on that push notification. The password's compromised. The MFA didn't help. Boom, you're in. So good passwords, good multi-factor on top of that, and just, yeah, and, you know, and nothing out in the wild that doesn't need to be. You know, these honeypots prove that more than anything else. If you put a remote desktop or SSH server out in the wild where any public IP can hit it, some of the bad actors are going to find it pretty quickly checking it for vulnerabilities.
Well, Darren, this has been great. That was some great suggestions there. You know, we appreciate you joining VMblog today. But before we let you go, where can folks go if they want to learn more about the company, the technology, and some of the things we talked about today?
SpecOpsSoft.com. I guess with a double S towards the end there. If you just go right there, you'll see where you can download the SpecOps Password Auditor tool we showed before. You can see information on our password policy products, our self-service password reset solutions, and there'll be contact forms right there if you want to reach out to learn any more than what you see on the site.
Great. Well, thanks again. Appreciate you taking time to talk to us today.
Yeah. Thanks again for having me.
All right. Take care.
Yeah, you too.